Now let's talk about medical science, blood flow. Suppose this is a human vessel and the blood is flowing through this vessel. Okay, let me make this mouth of the vessel like this. Now this is the mouth of the vessel, okay? This is the mouth of the vessel is going like this. Okay. Now if this is the mouth of the vessel, and I say that this is the total radius of the vessel. Now this is the central axis, the point. Like if I draw it here, then this is the central axis, the center of the vessel, the center of the circle. So the center of the circle, I draw a line there. This center line is actually the center of the vessel. And I say that if I take some small r like this, and I say this r is the distance from center towards wall. Means if I am standing, if something is here at the center of this vessel, and if you want to measure this distance, of course the whole distance from this point to this point is capital R. But if I am interested somewhere between here and I want to know only this distance from here to here, then I can say this is my small r, which is the point of interest, which is the point of interest that I want to know what is happening when I move from center towards wall. Suppose I'm standing at this point and I want to move from this point towards the wall, then what is happening? So actually we are talking about the flow of the blood from this vessel, and we are talking about the velocity of the blood at different positions of this vessel. I am interested to know that what will be the velocity at the central point and what will be the change in velocity at these points, at these positions from center to the wall. Okay, do you get my point? Do you get my point?
Yeah.
So I'm interested to know that what is the rate of change of the velocity from the center as compared to the wall. For example, I can give you an example that since the wall is a solid surface and of course it has friction. Now a fluid is flowing through the vessel. Of course the vessel is full of the blood and the fluid is flowing through the vessel. But the velocity of the fluid at all these points is different. Why it is different? Because at the center, there is no frictional force in contact with the blood. But the blood which is in contact with the wall, on the inner side of this wall, if this is the wall of the vessel, and the blood which is in contact with the inner surface of this wall, of course that blood is facing friction because of the inner wall of the surface. And if I say this molecule is actually in contact with the wall, and this molecule is connected with other molecules, and this one is the molecule at the center of the wall, and this whole thing is my vessel. Now I splitted the blood into molecules. This is one molecule and this is in contact with the wall from the inside. And of course when the blood is flowing, all the molecules are connected together. So of course they have some effect on each other. But what will happen? This molecule, if you look here, now this molecule, this one is actually at this point. And this molecule is actually at the central line. Now, the velocity of the molecule which is at the central line will be very high. as compared to the velocity of the molecule which is on the in contact with the surface. The reason is that the surface has friction, and the molecule of the water, molecule of the blood, he has to face the friction force as well, which is stopping the blood to move, which is stopping that molecule to move forward. And he is struggling to deal with the frictional force, and once he overcomes with the frictional force, then he moves one step forward. But the molecule which is on the central axis, he is actually facing no friction because he is at a very free space. He is at a very loose position. So of course he is not struggling, so he is moving faster. This guy is struggling, so he is moving less with the less speed. This guy is also happening, facing the same situation because this is on the other part of the surface. So the guys, the molecules which are in contact with the surface, their velocity is small. And similarly, now this one, suppose this is the least velocity, then of course the molecule next to it towards the center will have a little more than this. Then the molecule after this will have a little more than this because the frictional force is reducing towards center. And at the central point, the velocity is maximum. Now, they're again crossing the central point, now moving towards the other side of the wall. Again, now the central guy has maximum velocity, and the guy next to it towards this wall, he will have a little less than the center. And the guy next will have a little less, and so on, and up to surface it becomes. So you can see the people, the molecules directly in contact with the surface, they have less velocities on both sides. And the molecules which are on the mid of the, on this point, they are moving fast. I want to know that what is the change of this velocity from, let me say, the central point to somewhere here, and I say this is r. So I want to know that what is the change of velocity from the central point to somewhere here, not exactly on the wall, but in where, in between, somewhere here. This is the central point, and I want to know the velocity change in this portion. So I still have many space here to reach the wall, but I'm interested for this position. So I say this is my small r, and this whole thing actually, this is the radius capital R. So to calculate all this happening and to calculate the blood pressure, they have to calculate the velocity of the blood. They have a formula which is called the velocity V equals to the P. I will tell you what are this P. P divided by 4 eta L into the bigger radius, the total radius of the vessel, R square, minus the length of the portion of the distance of the portion which you are interested in, cap small r square. This is an equation which is used to calculate the velocity of the molecules of the blood at different positions from center towards the wall. Do you understand what is happening here?
Yes, I understand.
Good. This situation, this whole phenomena is called a laminar flow in terms of fluid mechanics, in terms of the viscous flows, because the blood has some kind of viscosity, and the blood is not viscous free. So actually this whole situation is a laminar flow, and a person whose name was Poiseuille, some bigger name, but I only know the last name, he actually worked on it, and he derived this equation for the doctors, that you can calculate the different velocity, the change in velocity, by using this equation. In this equation, this is the velocity of the blood. This P is the pressure difference at different ends of the vessel. Of course, there can be somewhere the pressure is loose, somewhere the pressure is high, and that pressure is also affecting the flow of the blood. If the vessels are squeezed, then of course the velocity will be higher. For example, if you go to the garden and you have a pipe of water and put your thumb on the tip of the pipe. Water is going out, but if you put the thumb on the tip of the pipe and you squeeze the pipe to a smaller gap, smaller opening, the water will move faster. Have you done this?
Yes,
so if you are playing with when you play with your siblings, you squeeze the pipe and the water force becomes higher and you tease them. And if you lose it, the water will move slowly out of it and the other person will not be teased. So the same things happening here. Somewhere, if the vessel is squeezed, if there is some mass which is creating disturbance in the blood flow, the speed of the blood will increase and the doctor will get an idea, okay, if this is the whole vessel and somewhere here, from this point, the velocity, the instantaneous velocity of the fluid at this point is higher as compared to these points. Then he will get an idea, okay, this point has some disturbance. Let us go closely to this point. And when they go closely to this point, they see that there is a mass which is actually striking on the vessel and the vessel is damaged, vessel is squeezed and the blood is flowing rapidly from that point. So they get the clear picture, okay? There is some mass from the outer edge and it is affecting the vessel. Anyways, all these happenings are actually based on the rate of change, which is a derivative. Now, in this equation, V is the velocity, P is the pressure difference of the vessel. Somewhere the pressure is high, somewhere low. 4 is the constant. Eta is called the viscosity of the blood. You know the viscosity? If you have glass of water and you... viscosity. No. Viscosity is a different thing. If you, for example, if you have a glass of water and you drop it on the floor, the water will go very rapidly down. But if you have a bottle of honey and you try to drop it down, it will be very slow to go down. Both are facing the same gravitational force. The water and the honey, both are facing the same gravitational force to go down. But because of the viscosity, the honey does not want to leave the surface of the glass. And he has to struggle to leave the surface of the glass. And that's why its velocity going downwards is slow. As compared to water, water has low viscosity and the water it does not struggle to leave the surface of the glass. Anyways, if we go deep into those things, then we will forget about this course. Yeah. We don't need to go there. But this is the viscosity of the blood.
Very boring. Bio.
Yeah. And this L is the length of the vessel. R, I already explained in detail what is R. It is the total radius of the vessel. And the smaller R is actually your desired location from the center of the vessel towards the wall of the vessel. So whatever your desired location is, you define it as R. Now, it varies. Of course, the vessels in human body, they have different dimensions as compared to vessels in the animals and all the, like a smaller bird, they have smaller vessels, a bigger animal, they have bigger vessels. So of course, this capital R changes. And the smaller R will also change. For example, if you have a blood vessel, this R, this is a human blood vessel. And if you want to analyze a bird vessel, then of course the bird vessel has no actual size as compared to the human blood vessel. So this location will also change. So these values change. And actually, your velocity is depending on what? Your velocity is depending on this distance which you want to measure, which you want to see from the center towards the wall, this smaller distance. So actually the velocity is dependent on the smaller distance. What does it mean? It means that if this R is small, near to the center position, the velocity will be maximum. If this R is large, near to the wall, the molecules which are in contact with the wall from inside, their velocity will be small because their distance from the center is large. So they have relation, and the velocity is actually depending on the distance from the center towards wall. The molecules on the wall will have lowest velocity. The molecules in the free space in the center of the circle, in the center of the vessel, will have the maximum velocity. So the velocity, this whole velocity is depending on the function r. So if you want to know the change in velocity, then it is dv by dr. And you know how to find the derivative of this equation. So you only need to find the derivative of this equation and plug in the values of r, r. These, whenever somebody will ask you a question, of course he will give you the values. All the values, these values are already available, are found experimentally. This eta, this is the viscosity of the blood. And the viscosity of the blood is already found, that a normal human being has this value of viscosity, an animal has this value. So all these values are found. So whenever somebody, if I ask you that find the rate of change of velocity of a human blood vessel, a human blood, then I will give you the value of eta, I will give you the pressure, I will give you the capital R, I will give you the L. The only thing which is unknown is the radius, which is the smaller r. So you can differentiate.
The only variable is the radius.
It depends how you want to analyze. Okay. It depends how you want to analyze the velocity. If I say that the small r is constant, their distance is constant, like in this case, but the pressure is varying. I say that the distance from center, from here to here, okay, wait.
You can find any variable if others are constant.
Yes. If I say that this is the central line of the vessel, and I say at every position, I say the smaller r, suppose this one, I fixed it as this, but I am saying that the pressure here is different as compared to the pressure here. But R, the smaller R is fixed. Capital R is of course fixed. That is the radius. Of course, a human vessel has a certain radius, which is fixed, constant. But I'm talking about the small r. But I also tell you that capital R is constant, but also the small r is also constant. I'm not worried about the location of the particles, but I want to know that what is the pressure change on the particle which are this distance apart from the central line. So the small r is also constant. The change is now in pressure. So in that case, this is the culprit and this becomes constant. So you can differentiate the velocity factor with respect to p, which is the variable. So of course, it depends on the situation and the person who is asking you something, he will define that what is the culprit, what is the variable, which is the reason of the change. For example, let's do a numerical for this one, the blood flow. For a human blood vessel, the value of eta is, now this is question statement, these things are given to us. The value of eta is 0.027. This symbol is called eta, the calligraphic N. In the calligraphic, N is called eta, and these symbols are used in mathematics for different constants. If the value of eta is 0.027 and the human blood vessel radius is 0.008 centimeter, this is the radius of human blood vessel, and I'm assuming the length of the blood vessel, I'm saying that I only consider this length of the blood vessel, and this whole length of the vessel is 2 centimeter. So I'm only interested about this portion of the blood vessel. I'm not interested about the blood vessel from heart to foot. No, I'm only interested about this part of the vessel. So L is also given to you, 2 centimeter. And the pressure P is given to you as 4,000 dynes. This is the unit of the pressure, dynes per centimeter square. So the pressure is also constant from here to here, and the pressure value is this constant. So wherever you go from this position to this position, the pressure on the vessel is constant. It is 4000 times per centimeter square. Then can you find the velocity V? How to find velocity V? Simply plug in the values 4000 divided by 4 into the value of eta 0.027, and 4 eta into L was 2 centimeter into the capital R square 0.008 whole square minus the smaller R square. Yes, smaller R square is the culprit. So it is the smaller R square. Now you can see the only two things are left here. One is velocity and one is the smaller R. All others are numericals. So you can simplify them and put them on a side. And when you apply the differential, you will only be worried about V and R. Now this is the velocity in terms of R. So the equation says that the velocity of the blood flowing through this part of the vessel is dependent on the value of R. And if I want to know the rate of change of velocity at a certain point, say at the point 1 centimeter, this is 0 centimeter and this is 2 centimeter, okay, the points, because the total length is, let me find the velocity at the point 1 centimeter somewhere here. And what is the change in velocity? Of course, I know the formula that the change in velocity is dv. Now, velocity is dependent on r, so it will be dv divided by dr. You can simply simplify these things and take the derivative of this whole equation with respect to r. It will become something like this, minus 2r. The derivative of r square is minus 2r. Now, I told you that we are not interested about this. I say that the R value of R is 1 centimeter. Then you can simply plug in the value of R here, and that is the rate of change of velocity when R is 1 centimeter. Do we understand?
Yes.
So you can calculate anything which is asked to you if you know the basic behind the concept of the things happening behind it. On paper, I have solved this whole question on detail, so you can read it and you already know what is happening. When you will read, you can understand the whole question numerically.